Hello everyone, welcome back. Conan Explets here. Yeah, it's been a while since the last video, especially in the Cisco Packet Tracer series of tutorials. And today I'm just doing a brief intro or sort of recap on what we've been trying to achieve. And I'll begin with looking at the Cisco Packet Tracer 7.3. And they say that they've improved some things, basically when it comes to the UI and configuration of your system, where you can have very specific names for very specific racks, as you see in real life. So this is geared towards helping networking students and even network designers and engineers to be better communicate to the people implementing or to the technical team exactly what it is they want achieved, on which rack you want certain devices, certain routers, switches, everything. You will be able to access updates, ability to deploy networking devices to very specific racks again, in terms of usability and being able to communicate through your work. New workspace themes is for beauty and everything. And then in terms of the protocol and software improvements, you'll notice slight or significant UI fixes. You also have IPv6, they've improved their OSPF protocol, and essentially making it more accessible or easier to access by shortening the commands. These are some of the things we'll see as we continue designing our office space. They've added some new devices. These are also new devices by Cisco in the market. So for instance, just a quick recap, we can look at how to place your devices, how to check what tools you can access on any device that you decide to add on your workspace. So coming over here immediately to the network devices, you'll notice all of them, and this is the one they've added. We can place that one. Let's look up what else have they added. They've added a LAN controller. Let's get this one started up quickly. And this is the LAN controller that they have added. We can also get it up and running, though now this one requires you having to telnet in. We'll do that in the next videos. So once the system is up, I always bypass this one. I'd like to set up my own network in a very specific manner. So if you don't know how to access the commands, you can quickly put in that question mark and it will show you everything that you can do. So to enter sort of super user mode, you just type in enable, tab, enter, and you're in. Question mark, it shows you every command that you can possibly run. If you want to configure, you can just type in configure, and we have configure terminal, blah blah blah. Yep, I want to configure the terminal, and we're into the configuration menu. From here I can set up my welcoming banner definitions, I can go into the telnetting, I can configure host names, IP, you can do so much more. And sometimes learning is all about knowing how to access these commands, because at the end of the day no one knows everything in terms of network design or maybe this specific software, Packet Tracer. Even the best of the best, they still learn at the end of the day. You'll maybe not in terms of commands, but also in terms of how you approach your work. And essentially it's all about something like the Kaizen principle, why it's all about continuous improvement. Yeah, so thank you for watching. If you like the videos, if you like the series, hit that thumbs up button, and I'll be seeing you next week as we continue with that part of the small office space that we were designing in the last two videos. Thank you.